welcome to my channel. So in the today's lecture, we are going to discuss one more example of stop and wait. So the question is, we have to transmit packets from 1 to 10. Each and every packet which you are transmitting to the receiver is given a sequence number. So what is my question? I am sending 1 to 10 packets onto the channel in a sequence. And what happens every fifth packet, every fifth packet which you are transmitting is lost. So how many total number of packets you will be transmitting on the channel? So how many total number of packets you will be transmitting on the channel? So that is our question. So what I have a 10 number of packets like this. So what is question? Every fifth packet is lost. So I transmitted first packet, I got the acknowledgement. Similarly, till the packet number 4, we received all the acknowledgements of the first 4 packets back from the receiver. So we are sure that our four packets has been delivered to the receiver successfully. Now what we are doing, we are transmitting our packet number 5th. This is our packet number 5th. We are transmitting it, and this packet got lost. This packet got lost in the network. And what happened? We got timeout timer. So what basically is timeout timer? When you are sending any packet on the channel, you are fixing some timeout timer. If within that time you got acknowledgement back from the receiver, then that means your packet has delivered successfully. But if within the timeout timer, or in the time which you fixed before sending the packet, you don't get any acknowledgement back from the receiver, what does it mean? Your packet is lost. You have to retransmit your packet. So similarly, we got timeout timer when we sent packet number 5th. Our packet 5th is lost. We didn't get acknowledgement back from the receiver. So how we will be dealing with this situation? We have to retransmit the packet number 5. So I am again transmitting packet number 5 on the channel. So now every fifth packet is lost. So this fifth packet is lost. Now I am transmitting this fifth packet again. So I will be counting from here. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then I transmitted packet from 5 to 8. All these 4 packets, 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. All packets delivered successfully to the receiver, and we got acknowledgement within time out. Okay, within timeout timer, we got acknowledgement back from the receiver for these 4 packets, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, when we were sending the packet number 9, we got timeout timer. You know, we didn't get acknowledgement back for the packet number 9. Then what we had to do? We had to retransmit this packet on the channel. Why? Why we did retransmitting? Because our packet number 9 had been lost. So we had no other option rather than retransmitting the packet number 9. So we retransmitted packet number 9 on the channel. Then if you count, we don't have any 5. packet number 9. Because you don't get 5 packets after 9. So how many packets you are transmitting on the channel? Total number of packets is 12. 10 packets are your original, but out of which 2 packets were lost and you had to retransmit these packets again. How many transmissions you are doing on the channel? 12. And how many retransmissions we have? How many retransmission? 2. We are doing 2 retransmission. Which packets you are retransmitting? 5 and 9. 5 and 9. So this is how we solve this kind of problems. So I hope that you have got a good idea that how we could solve this kind of problems. So thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel.